Jasper, do you want to go for a walk? Three, two, one, go! Oh, good job! Sit. Catch. Good job, buddy. All right, let's go. Plug your channel.
Yeah, man. Downey Live Adventure Experience.
Get out of here. Jess, let's go. Alright, so we're just gonna pretend that this isn't my third cup of coffee for the day and it is barely noon. But guys, this cold brew. Absolutely no regrets. And also, if you guys saw my previous video, look how aesthetic this pasta sauce jar looks. Guys, if you're still out here buying mason jars, stop it. Reuse your old pasta jars, because look at this. So lately, small spaces have been quite romanticized on social media, whether it's studio apartments, whether it's van life, whether it's tiny homes. However, I feel that for the most part, people really only share the good parts, not really the shitty parts. And I'm talking like real shitty parts, like literal poop, like poop smells in a small space. So today I thought I would compile my 4 years experience living in a studio apartment and just share some reasons why micro living may not be for you, and that's all right. So speaking of smells, obviously when you live in a smaller space, the little smell particles are going to diffuse throughout the air, whether it's your food or your poop. Now, when it comes to the poop, thankfully, my current studio layout, the bathroom is separated away from the main living slash sleeping space, and there's a hallway separating the two. Plus, I've got a very good extractor fan in the bathroom, so the poop smells are not an issue at all. However, my very first studio was in an older building, and the bathroom connected directly to the living slash sleeping space. So you best believe when your animal corpse eating buddies come over and take a little dookie, you are going to be smelling that in your living space. Plus, because it was an older building, it didn't have a bathroom extractor fan. So all the smells were just, it was everywhere. So when I turn on the extractor fan, it's really not an issue. Plus, because of the layout of the apartment, when I open the windows as well as the front door, this apartment is in a weird like outdoor kind of courtyard style. So in the hallway, it's not a typical hallway. It's literally kind of the outside, if that makes sense. So once I crack both doors open, I get a ton of natural draft coming from the outdoor. So it really helps circulate the air. And also for those of you guys that remember, but in my previous studio apartment, there was like a massive ceiling fan in the living space. So that really helped move the air around. So yeah, there are definitely ways to get around it. But if you are sensitive to smells, I would highly recommend getting a new studio that has really good airflow and ventilation. Another point that's really important for those of you guys who are considering living in a small space is that you really have to learn to clean as you go. For those of you guys who have seen my benefits of living in a studio apartment, the main thing I talk about is how quick it is to clean up. But as quick it is to clean up, it's even easier to make a mess, because if your living room gets messy, then your bedroom is messy, then your dining room is messy, and your whole space is messy because it's literally just one big rectangular box. You really do have to be constantly cleaning, especially if you have a lot of guests over. You don't have the room or capacity to just chuck all your mess into a separate room and it'll all be fine. You can't just, you know, hide the dirty dishes in the sink because you have a tiny ass sink, because you live in a tiny ass studio. So you really just have to be disciplined and just remember to put shit back after you're done using it. And that goes for everything, whether that's the condiments, your clothes, dishes, etc. Just put it back after you're done, because, you know, in a bigger home, that localized mess is just a localized mess. However, in a studio, that mess is literally every room's mess. Personally, I don't see constantly cleaning as a con, just because I have become very efficient with it. But for those of you guys who don't like to clean as you go, then maybe a small space or micro living just isn't for you. The next thing I want to talk about are the sounds. Now, because you live in a single room, you hear everything, whether it's the humming of the fridge, whether it's the washing machine, whether it's the vacuum, whether it's your dog licking his own pee-pee. Jasper, can you please stop? You really have nowhere to go to escape it. Now, when I was living in my first studio, which was an older building, you could hear your neighbors do everything, whether it's talking, when they have their guests over, when they're doing their late night exercises. You hear it all. So I would highly recommend, if you are very sensitive to sounds as well, try to get a studio that has a little bit of separation in its layout, meaning that, you know, the kitchen is a little bit further away from the main living space. And also, newer steel cement structures are a lot more soundproof than the older wooden ones. So definitely just keep those things in mind. So thankfully, my previous two studios have been very, very new. So the noises from the neighbors have not been an issue at all. And you just have to work around things. Like when you're running your appliances, like washer and dryer, just do it when you are gone. Same thing when I'm running the vacuum, I just do it when we go for our walks. We don't use the dishwasher just because we only have two plates and two bowls, but you just have to make things work, create systems that work for your lifestyle so that you don't, you know, obviously run the dishwasher when you have a very important conference call, you know? You just gotta use your brain a little bit. But I would also highly recommend, especially if you're living with another person, pick up a nice pair of over-the-ear noise-canceling headphones. Trust me, you won't regret it. Now, speaking of partners, let's talk about the lack of privacy. Now, this really didn't pertain to me when I was living on my own, but now that I am cuffed, a lot of things have changed. But because my partner is away at work for the vast majority of the day, it really hasn't been too big of an issue because I'm still able to focus on my work for the entire day. But I think for those couples where both of the people work from home, that's where I guess the privacy issues can arise, just because you are constantly looking at them and they're constantly in your space because you only have a finite amount of space. Now, obviously there are definitely ways to get around this. You guys can face away from each other. You guys can try to create separate working spaces, especially now because a lot of people are working from home due to the virus. But obviously it's gonna be a lot different than if you were to live in a big house with three bedrooms, a separate office suite, etc. So currently for our lifestyle, the studio has been absolutely no problems. But yeah, for those couples who are working a lot from home, maybe you guys can go work at different coffee shops just so you get a little bit of separation throughout the day. But yeah, like I mentioned, at the end of the day, it really does come down to your individual lifestyles. You know, maybe get a one bedroom plus a den and you can turn that den into like a separate office slash working space. But yeah, the lack of privacy, especially if both of you guys spend a lot of time at home, can be an issue for some people. The last point I want to touch on is quite obvious, but I think is very important, but there is a clear limitation of space and what you can bring into your apartment. One of the first questions you're really going to have to learn to ask yourself is, where am I going to put this? Because you don't have an endless supply of square footage that you can just chuck useless shit into. Everything has to be very intentional, purposeful, or you just really, 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 really love it. For example, my current studio does not have an oven, even when my previous studios all had an oven. So I really want to get a toaster oven. However, I just don't have the counter space for it. So I really just have to learn how to make things work. Like, it's not a necessity, but it'd be really, 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 really nice to have. So that's one thing I'm kind of going back and forth on where I can put it. Maybe I can move some stuff around. But yeah, you really have to consider the actual physical limitations of your space before investing in things. Now, because I already focus on intentionality and things serving a purpose, it hasn't really been too big of an issue. But I think for those people who are trying to downsize, just, you know, for the sake of downsizing, or maybe just want to keep things more simple, or they just want to save more money, you really have to be intentional with the things you keep. So just keep that in mind. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Those were some of the cons and downsides of living in a studio apartment. I personally don't really consider them downsides. I think it's all a framing of your mindset, people say, but I really do think it does come down to that. I think having physical limitations can be a good thing for certain people, especially if you are purposeful with it. I personally really enjoy not having a lot of square footage that dog hair can just collect in. I really do enjoy living in micro suite, and it works for my current lifestyle. I'm not saying that I'm gonna live in a studio apartment for the rest of my life, because, you know, I don't know what that's gonna look like, and I don't know what I'm gonna need in 5-10 years, but for now, studio apartments have been amazing, and yeah, I love it. If you guys have any other questions about living in small spaces, micro living, studio apartments, etc., you guys can leave them in the comment section down below. Other than that, if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and remember to be less shitty.